Today, I'm going to be going over my nightly routine for skincare, and I'm also going to be going over some fun skincare tips that I have been collecting over the last week. So let me go ahead and get into this. I have not worn any makeup today. It was Sunday. It's Sunday night now. Only thing I did was my brows, so I'm going to go ahead and cleanse my face and do everything that I normally would, but only step that I'm missing is that step one, I would have already taken off my makeup, so we're skipping that. Also, this hair. If you want to get some nice, you know, like waves going on while you sleep, put it right here. I actually move a lot around. I move around a lot in my sleep, so I don't even know if this is going to stay, but it doesn't matter. All right, step one. We're going to give ourselves a mini microabrasion facial. And the first tip is get some rest. So, as far as like every single beauty blog site that I could find on skincare tips, that was the most commonly one found, and it's just unanimous. You want to get some rest, you know? If you're the type of person that has like bags under your eyes or gets, I don't know, just everybody, and I'm sure if you've like paid attention, looks a lot better when they get some sleep. It's called beauty sleep for a reason, guys. So I'm just gonna get rid of all of that gunk. Oh gosh. Like I said, I didn't wear any makeup today, and this is like still dirty because this little gem here is really good about getting rid of stuff, getting rid of all your little impurities. Impure. And I'm squinting because I don't have my glasses on, so ignore that. Step two is healthy from the inside out. Ooh, yes. Okay, so obviously we know that like you are what you eat. So it's really important to be eating your greens, but specifically citrus. So there's a reason, there's another good reason to drink lemon water in the morning. It is good for digestion, but it's also really good for your skin. So yeah, snack on citrus. You can get yourself some either oranges or lemon water, maybe a grapefruit in the morning if you're, you know, being a model for a day. So yeah, eat citrus. And like honestly guys, what you eat, if you have skin problems, a lot of what's going on in your skin has to do with your gut. So even if you think you're eating clean, you might want to take a second look at what it is that you're eating, and I'll go more into that a little bit later. Tip number three. Oh yes, massage your moisturizer in circular motions. So the reason for this is that it helps to stimulate, you know, your blood vessels from just like getting all excited and all worked up, and you want to just activate it, you know, kind of waken it up. So sometimes people, you'll see people like slapping their face in the morning. You don't need to do that. What you can do is just massage your moisturizer in. Tip number four. Also, we're still on the last tip. If you're massaging your moisturizer or any of your products in, it's always good to use a applicator, like the one I'm using, that doesn't absorb the product. So whether you're buying expensive makeup or cheap makeup, I mean skincare, you don't want it to be absorbed. You know, you want to get the most bang for your buck, no matter what price you're paying. So it's kind of the same concept as, you know, might have known as like the silly sponge. So a lot of people right now are using beauty blenders with their makeup, and a brand came out with this thing called a silly sponge. I think that's what it's called, actually. That might be wrong. It kind of sounds wrong the more I say it. But basically, what it does is, it's just like this, kind of like this piece of rubber that you put your foundation on. And the whole point of it, reason why I'm like rambling, the whole point of it is just so that it doesn't, you can, it doesn't absorb your foundation like a beauty blender does, because beauty blenders are made out of sponge. So you can get yourself one of these. Ones that vibrate are the best because they help to vibrate and warm. Vibrate helps to get it into your pores, your moisturizer, and if it warms, it's even better because it helps open up your pores, so it's like really getting your product in. And so it's not just sitting on the top of your face, not being useful. Okay, number four. Skincare tip number four. Apply your products from thinnest to thickest. So most companies will tell you what to use, like what order to use their products in. If they don't tell you, you can go by consistency. So that is for reasons that are, I don't want to say obvious reasons, but that's just so that the when it seeps into your skin and your skin's absorbing it, it's just most effective. And now we're gonna go in with my night cream. Step number five. Okay, so yeah, that was step number four. Step number five. Thin skin. Okay, so step number, or tip number five, is to use a product that helps create a barrier for your skin. So I'm talking about, this is when we're getting into the thicker consistencies, like if you use something that has SPF in it, that's a perfect example of a product that has a barrier in it, because it is a layer that is created that's not meant to seep into your skin completely. The sunscreen is not meant to seep into your SPF. Usually their molecules are a lot bigger than the size of your pores. So it nicely just sits on top of your skin, almost like a makeup primer, and protects you from, you know, outside air pollution. It protects you from the sun. Just helps protect you from any kind of unwanted light or just anything that could be damaging to your skin, because there's a lot of stuff that is damaging to your skin. Oh, also, I was watching a Nikki Tutorials video, and she was talking about how, not she, she did a video with Beyonce's makeup artist, and he was talking about how this eye skin and your lip skin is the same. So you can use an eye cream on your lips. Like, I've heard people talking about using their eye creams all over their face, because obviously if it's safe enough for your eyes, which is the most delicate part of your face, then it's good enough for the rest of your skin, right? So I've heard people talking about it all over, but it's the first time I heard somebody talking about it being good for your lips, especially if they said if you're using a matte lipstick, which I normally don't wear, but maybe you do. So I don't know, give that a try. It sounds kind of interesting and fun. Number six. Is to exfoliate, but only twice a week. And the reason to exfoliate in the first place is because obviously we are reproducing new skin cells every single day. And if you don't exfoliate your face, then you're kind of making your face look dull, because you're not getting rid of that like outer layer that's like dead and like should have been gotten rid of. And why it's twice a week and not every single day is because it's too harsh for your skin. Okay, your skin can't take constant scrubbing down. So if that's something that you do, it's going to age you prematurely. So you should probably stop doing it. Even if you have good skin right now, you're just gonna cause wrinkles. And if you have bad skin and you're exfoliating every day thinking that's going to help, it is not. It's too hard on your skin. Okay, so only twice a week. And number seven. Sleep the right way. Ooh, this is an interesting one. So I always thought about this, is that it matters how you sleep, okay? So if you sleep on your stomach with your face in your pillow, no. So you want to sleep, and also if you sleep on your back with like the weight of the gravity just like pulling your face back, that's also bad. So what you want to do is I don't know where, it doesn't matter. So, okay, right. So tech neck is something that we all need to be aware of. It is something that is new to our generation. Okay, it's called tech neck for a reason. It's because we're on our phones and we're sitting on our beds, like on the laptop like this. And all of that creates a line, that almost a permanent crease slash wrinkle that can be on your neck. And you can help prevent this by remembering to bring your skincare routine down to your neck. Bring your moisturizer down, your cleanser down, just like incorporate your neck, you know, your neck. You should be doing your skincare routine from the neck up. And also you can like be doing like some neck exercises as in stretching and stuff like that. Number nine is, skincare tip number nine, circulation. So if you do yoga, you're already doing this. So you want to be hanging upside down at least once a day. And why I talk about yoga is because that happens when you're doing down dog. So the reason why you want to be hanging upside down and why it's helpful because when you hang upside down, it causes your obviously blood to rush to your head. And when that happens, it just helps promote like new blood coming to your face, because if you've noticed, your blood pumps from the center of your heart. So your hands, feet, and head are like the last things to get like in that nice new cycle of blood. So you can help make sure that you're getting lots of oxygen and nutrients to your face by making sure that you hang upside down at least once a day. So basically tip number nine is just do yoga for your skin. Or just to do downward dog, at least. Maybe just a sun salutation. And tip number 10, skincare tip number 10, is to wear sunscreen. Now, I wear products that already have sunscreen in them, so that is usually the way to go. 'Cause a lot of sunscreens have a lot of gross chemicals in them that you do not want to be putting on your face, especially on a daily basis. Like, there's a reason why when you put sunscreen on and it gets in your eyes, it burns. It's because it's not good stuff. So try to find it in your skincare, or try to find a brand that is vegan, that you know isn't putting like toxic chemicals. Vegan, you want it to be vegan, plant, and plant-based. So they're not putting like toxic gross chemicals in the skin sunscreen. So that is the last tip. Oh, I stabbed my eye with my hair. That is the last tip, guys. I want to thank you so much for watching. I'm going to be filming another tip video soon, maybe, possibly. Let me know what you guys want to know a little more about. I can keep going with skincare. I can go with skincare all day long. But yeah, that is the end of my video. Thank you so much for watching. Please don't forget to subscribe. And I will see you guys. Oh, my glasses are so dirty. I hope you can't see this. I will see you on the next one. Oh, it's just, you know, it's late. It's bedtime. It's been a day. I'll see you on the next one. Love you. Thank you so much for watching.